Maurice Ravel's fairy tale opera, L'Enfant et les Sortilèges, The Child and the Spells, Magic Spells. When this recording appeared in 1961, it created a sensation, and most of all because of the dazzling, virtuoso brilliance that conductor Lorin Maazel achieved in the vividly pictorial orchestral colours and the impeccable way that he integrated them into the theatrical performances of the singing cast. We're in the living room of a country house in northern France. A six-year-old boy is supposed to be doing his homework. Well, son hopes. He's bored out of his mind with it. And when mother comes in and sees that he hasn't done anything at all, she's very upset and tells him off. But then she says, "Promise me you'll do your homework, baby." The child sticks his tongue out at mother.
Voici le goûter d'un méchant enfant. Du thé sans sucre, mais du pain sec. Restez tout seul jusqu'au dîner.
For that, you'll have dry bread and no sugar in your tea, and you'll stay here on your own until supper. So, when she's gone, the little boy smashes the whole place up. He knocks the teapot and Chinese cup off the table, he kicks the kettle over, he breaks the grandfather clock pendulum, and he tears up all his homework books and his other books. Everything the child attacked comes to life, beginning with the armchair, who dances with a shepherdess who's painted in another chair.
Votre serviteur, humble bergère.
Votre servante, fauteuil.
Débarrassé à jamais de cet enfant au talent méchant.
Many people feel that this performance has never been equaled on record, in character, in atmosphere, and in electrifying virtuosity. And it was especially the highly idiomatic French style of Lorin Maazel's conducting with the Orchestre National de France, an orchestra with which he enjoyed a very happy relationship, that won him his very highest plaudits in this iconic recording.
I've worked with French orchestras for years. I started conducting the Orchestre National in 1957, and also the Concert Amoureux, l'Orchestre du Conservatoire, Orchestre de Paris, and all of these remarkable orchestras, remarkable sound.
Yep.
And after all, Ravel, Debussy certainly wrote their masterpieces with this sound in mind, for the French bassoon and the sound of the French oboe and the French horn. And so, as a result of having worked with these orchestras for so long, it was my pretension and perhaps overweening pride in my 30s, 20s and 30s, to conduct the music of a country in that country and to become known for that music within that country. And so that's why I was conducting Wagner and Bayreuth and Mozart and Salzburg and French music and in France. It was no accident. It was, as I say, my pride. And whether or not it was overweening or not, I don't know, but I certainly learned a great deal in the process of obliging myself to make music within a certain tradition and then mastering that tradition to the extent that I would be able to express something personal about the music within that particular framework. It's very instructive.
and conducting the music of this composer, Johann Strauss, in the country of his birth was a very particular pride and joy for Lorin Maazel. In the next podcast, we hear from members of the Vienna Philharmonic Orchestra how profoundly they admired him, and most especially as their many times coveted chosen conductor of their annual New Year's Day concert.
He was a very good listener, and especially for this Johann Strauss music, he listened very much to the orchestra and he gave the music some form, but he respected the character the orchestra played this music.